Welcome to my studio's spring recital. Of course, because of COVID, most of them are on different continents and time zones for the weekly teaching. And even if virtually, they will come together today for you, playing their best from what they've studied. And I must say that it was an incredible challenge and joy to keep the attention to each individual student's progress while in this occasion bringing them to feel as a group, even if for the time being more or less not together, few of whom are still in Bloomington and some others are already, since the last semester already, far away. But the Zoom technology allows to keep that quality of giving of oneself, to give the best of ourselves, and to expect that weekly, and to assess that on a longer term, obviously. And I find that to be a beautiful dedication to continue and pursue this work on bettering oneself, serving the muse.
Thank you. Thank you.
Guo Chen will play for you the first partita by Bach.
Thank you.
Emery will play for you Rachmaninoff's Elegy.
Thank you.
Wichiol will play for you Chopin Sonata No. 3, slow movement.
Thank you.
Jokyun will play for you Vine's First Sonata's first movement.
Thank you.
João will play for you the finale with Fugue of Beethoven's Sonata Opus 101.
Thank you.
Jaume will play for you Dutilleux Sonata's Chorale and Variations.
Thank you.
will play for you Boulez's 12 Notations.
Thank you.
Grace will play for you Dupont's Coquetterie from Les Heures Dolentes.
Thank you.
will play for you Scriabin's Fantasy Opus 28. Gabe will play for you Chopin's G minor nocturne.
Thank you.
Lawrence will play for you Haydn sonatas in E flat major slow movement.
Thank you.
Huang will play for you Chopin Sonatas number 2, the Funeral March.
Thank you.
for you Schubert's C minor sonata's slow movement.
Thank you.
Oliver will play for you Beethoven's B-flat major sonata's last movement.
Thank you.
fresh one will play for you Ravel's Sonatine.
Thank you.
Shuan and her singer will present a few songs which she composed this semester.
Ode to drinking water from my hands,
which today in the garden I'd forgotten, I'd known, and more forgotten I'd learned. I was taught this by my grandfather, who, in the midst of a raging and watering, the small bouquets and mostly the freshest graves, saw my thirst and cranked the rusty red pump, bringing forth from what sounded like the gravelly throat of an animal, a frigid torrent. And with his hands made a lagoon from which he drank, and then I drank before he cranked again, making of my hands now a fountain in which I can see the silty bottom drifting while I drink and drink and. My grandfather waters the flowers on the graves, among which are his and his wife's unfinished and patient, glistening. After he rinses the bird shit from his wife's, pump exhales, and I drink to the bottom of my fountain. And join him in his work. Friends, goldfinch kissing the sunflower again and again, dangling upside down by its tiny claw, steadying itself by snapping open like an old timey fan. It tumbled off and swooped back to the very same perch where the sunflower curled its giant swirling of seeds around the bird and leaned back to admire the soft wind nudging the bird's plumage. And friends, I could see the points on the flower's stately crowns soften and curl inward as it almost indiscernibly lifted the full of its body to the bird's muzzling mouth. This feather I could hear from all 20 or 30 feet away, and see from the tiny halls that sailed from their gold racket, which gold racket I have to say was making me blush and rock up on my tippy toes and just barely purse my lips with what I realize now was being simply glad. Which such love, if we let it, makes us feel.
Si Papas will play for you Naumov's Passacaglia Fugata.
Thank you. Thank you.
For having attended my studio student's spring recital, coming to you from so many continents. Thank you, and goodbye.